I look at this lineup like the a war machine. Ang TNT Tropang Giga, Carlo, they are looking all kinds of good on paper. These additions, the biggest one, of course, being JP Eran, pero with Ray Ray Parks having more time with them. And still, of course, Jason Castro's there, Troy Rosario's there, RR Pogoy is there, and a handful of other insertions into this lineup. This team is looking as deadly as ever.
Abangan niyo po yung ginagawa naming storya sa One Sports featuring JP Aram because it's a really good story. Nung magkahapon binigay yung mga bagong uniform nitong TNT Tropang Giga. And it was a special moment for the rookies and for JP Aram. Parang ninanamnam niya talaga nung pagkabigay sa kanya ng jersey because it was a jersey that he was not able to wear for TNT when they drafted him. Hindi siya nakapaglaro, no? He was stuck as a practice player for TNT up until napasukan nga tayo ng dalawang additional teams in Kia back then and Blackwater. He was picked as a dun sa dispersal draft. Never got the opportunity to wear the proud jersey of TNT. Now, sila yung naghabol para kunin siya. They made an effort to be able to get him from NLEX because they think that he is the final piece to the puzzle. Tingin nila siya yung makakatulong talaga to push TNT over the top. And if you pair him with that deep of a talent pool, eh talaga namang, alam mong may balak itong TNT to really stay here in the PBA bubble until December.
So JP Aram definitely will have a big role, but as we mentioned, yung ibang insertions into this lineup, a guy like Simon Enciso. First TNT went for Mike De Gregorio. He didn't really fit in. Mm-hmm. In that short time he had with this squad last season, so nagpunta siyang Alaska. Simon Enciso yung naging kapalit. Ito yung paminsan-minsan merong win-win trade eh. So, kung tignan natin, Carlo, because looks like both of those guys might just need a fresh start. We're looking at a big role here for Simon Enciso. Of course, meron pa rin namang veterans katulad ni Ryan Reyes. Another rookie in Kib Montalbo, but I'm still looking at that big three. Castro, Pogoy, Rosario, that core of TNT. Now with the insertion of Eram and Ray Ray Parks, yun po ang magdadala dito sa Tropang Giga.
Grabe, no? Sinasabi natin. I mean, I definitely agree with you, Maguna. Yun yung big three because they've been there the longest. Castro, Pogoy, and Rosario. But you are mentioning a big three and saying that Ray Ray Parks is also in the same sentence. Diba parang ganun kalalim yung TNT ka tropa, and you have to give credit to their management and the work that they put in to be able to collect a talent pool this deep. Tanong mago, best player of the conference nominee, is it the time finally for Jason Castro?
Ano yung sabi nung naghawak ng sign dun sa August 10, 2013? Kung hindi ngayon, kailan pa? Di ba? Yun yung famous sign na ano dun, tuwan-tuwa ako dun na ginrab ko yun, nag-IG pa ako nung sign na yun. Pero this is the time para kay Jason Castro. He's finished runner-up to June Mars so many times or around the vicinity, Mythical 5 around the vicinity of being runner-up. Malas siya kasi he's lived in the time of Junmar. Now Junmar's not in the bubble. It's open season para dito sa MVP award. This may be Jason Castro's best chance.
For those asking kung may Leo Awards po for the 45th season of the PBA, hindi pa tayo nakakuha ng kalinawan coming from the PBA office. Because, you know, you have to understand that all their efforts right now are focused on the bubble. Ito pa lang po talaga because it takes so much concentration, so much planning just to be able to make this a success. No, pupunta tayo dun sa AUF Arena Magu and we see just how tightly guarded everything is. As in, hindi pwedeng lumabas yung mga wala sa bubble, yung mga pumapasok kahit gamit lang, kailangan i-disinfect ng maigi because we're really hoping that we do all of the things that are necessary to keep the bubble safe. So hanggang dun po muna yung Leo Awards. I think we can wait. We can start talking about that maybe later in the conference.
And again, bukas second game day pa lang of the 2020 season. Last game day, we just had the Leo Awards. Nag-Leo Awards tayo tapos opening nung March 8. So,
pakiramdam nung last game, parang tatlong taon na yung nakalipas.
216 days ago, bukas pang 217. Pero yun yan, no? Antayin na lang natin siguro pagka pa-playoffs na. Diyan, magsisimula na magka-planuhan. Huwag po ngayon, nagko-concentrate pa po tayo na maisampa muna to para lahat po tayo. Eh, makabalik sa konting sense of normalcy, meron na tayong matutukan gabi-gabi na live basketball. Enjoyin muna natin bago natin hanapin yung mga hindi pa naman kailangan sa ngayon. Di ba?
Magu, in terms of rookies, I am high on Kib Montalbo. Nakausap ko na rin yung mga assistant coaches, pati si Kuya Bong ng TNT. Sabi niya, ano, palaban, palaban yung bata. And, you know, it's really the only thing that you need to show if you're a rookie. Maraming talented, maraming maganda yung pedigree, but if you show that you are willing to fight, if you are willing to compete, at makita yun ng coach mo, it will mean that you will get opportunities.
So yun, naabangan natin if Kib Montalbo can really dal, karelyebo mo, Castro, at etong si Simon Enciso. They also got a veteran free agent in Almond Vosotros. So kailangan patunayan talaga ni Montalbo yung tibay na loob niya if he wants to actually get minutes in this rotation, di ba? Heavy minutes at that.
Yep. I think the biggest issue for TNT is what they could get out of their bench. Because if you're starting with Castro, Pogoy, Parks, Rosario, and JP Eram, that is a really good unit. I mean, that could match up against any five in the entire PBA all day. But what do you get from the other guys who are coming in? From your veterans? Ano makuha mo from Kuya Ryan, from Kuya Harvey? Ano makukuha mo from Simon Enciso, from David Semerad even? So I think that will be the challenge for the TNT Tropang Giga.
I absolutely love, by the way, that Harvey Carey is still in this lineup. I think Udonis Haslem ng TNT.
Yep.
He's the UD of this guy, basketball IQ off the charts. Yung kanyang physical commitment to the game, nandoon pa rin talagang hindi nagpapabaya ng katawan, hindi nagpapabaya ng kanyang laro, very responsible, and yung veteran presence niya, napaka-importante para dito sa tropa. And all of that will be on display right away, bukas na bukas po. First game of the restart will be TNT versus Alaska. Right there and then, fireworks are expected, Carlo.
Ay, sobrang excited na ako, Magu. Baka mahirapan ako matulog ngayong gabi just because of how, you know, excited we all are. Magu, we were able to have a phone call while I was in AUF Arena. At narinig mo yung tunog nung sahig. That alone is music to our ears.
Kikwento natin. Si Carlo nandun, nanonood ng mga ensayo. Kami po ni Guaps, yung ating super producer / director dito sa 2OT, natahimik bigla. Hindi kami makapagkwentuhan bigla kasi narinig lang po namin yung talbog ng bola, langit-ngit ng sapatos, yung paglusot ng bola sa net, at pati yung pito ng referee. Yun pa lang po, may konting sigawan, may konting alam mong medyo hingal sa takbuhan, pero yung certain sounds na yon, langit-ngit ng sapatos, talbog ng bola, yung swoosh ng net at saka yung pito ng referee. Ibe, parang natahimik lang po kami doon sa phone call na yan for a good maybe 10 seconds. Parang, dali, pakinig lang tayo. Tapos ngayon iniisip mo, bukas po, lahat tayo makakarinig na ulit ng ganun. Iba po yung pakiramdam, iba po yung, bukas palang, for a commentator, I'm running out of words. I guess bukas, maybe we can start putting into words because we have to. Because it's our job tomorrow. Pero until I actually hear it for myself, na ganun, actual game, tumatakbo, I don't know how to describe it, I guess.
In behalf of, you know, PBA fans from all over the country, Magu, excited na rin kaming marinig ka ulit. Boses mo with your analyst, the exceptional Coach Ryan Gregorio on the call. So, all around, just intense excitement coming from the PBA family, from the fans to the teams. And we're all excited to share this moment with you. We will be there. Tweet with your hashtags, yung PBA Bubble, PBA Tuloy Ang Laban. At kita-kita po tayo bukas ng alas 4. Let's all watch. Let's all talk about it on social media. Let's all relive the good old days na hindi ganito yung mga kabigat, yung mga pinoproblema natin sa mundo. So, Magu, I'm sure you're excited. I'm excited. And really, we're just so happy that the PBA is back. Yeah.